You're all friendly and powerly off the track around the back of the pit. As soon as you strap yourself in, visor goes down, it's the horns are out and the red mist starts.
Unfortunately, Craig is loved by everyone and he can do no wrong.
We come here to the Holy Grail, Bathurst 1000, and they turned him around on the exit of turn one, which he made a mistake, obviously.
I don't think the sun got in that day. It wasn't that bad. We wear visors, which are like sunglasses, so I think he just got one into me.
He wasn't too pleased. He didn't say too much, but hopefully my apology was there and we got on with life, which I think, touch wood, you never know with him.
I'm Chris Danks. Thanks to Barbeques Galore, we're here at Mount Panorama. We're going to get two of Australia's greatest sporting legends around the flame. Mark Winterbottom, Craig Lowndes. Get in here, guys.
Hey, mate.
How are you?
How you going?
G'day, boss.
Hey, mate. Hey.
Guys, let's get into it. Mount Panorama, it's the place of places. You've won it seven times. What does it take to win here?
Good team. You need a good team, good car, good strategy, a little bit of luck. 6.5 hours or 161 laps, you know, just intense racing all day. It's pretty special at the end of it.
Frosty, you've also won. Great year for you, but also 2014, not so great. Lap 154, we have to talk about it. What happened?
Yeah, 13 was fantastic.
Let's just talk about that.
That's probably the best Bathurst has ever been. But then 14, there was a beautiful day, very similar to this actually. Not many clouds to cover the sun, because that sun's quite a powerful tool, isn't it? And those visors we wear don't really stop the sunlight. Well, mine does, but most don't. So Craig and I were in a good position that day, cruising around the mountain with heaps of fuel when everyone else didn't. Yeah, we made contact. There was a bit of sun at turn one and just bumped me in the back.
Honest mistake. Yeah, right.
Yeah. It was like Braille. I couldn't see. It was sort of like, there you are. Oh, sorry. Yeah, but as soon as that happened, I knew we were okay. Game over. It was like, no. Because as Frosty said, like the other guys in front had limited fuel. We had good tyres, good fuel. We could run hard and fast to the finish. It was just one of those moments.
Oh, right. As he was saying before, obviously it may have been your fault. It happens.
It happens. Yeah, we're drivers. Look, the driver, when you start racing supercars, rule 101, when you read the handbook is, it's not your fault, it's the other person's fault. So we're all educated by that same book. So, but hey, that's what Bathurst is. That's what racing is. You sit on the red side, which Craig was then. You sit on the blue side, which I was. My supporters think it's his fault. His supporters think it's my fault. That's racing, that's sport. And another rivalry will happen next week, because when that person crashes into you, he's forgotten and the next bloke comes
on. The funny thing is, he's right, because we race against each other like almost every second weekend. Like footy teams, you might have a battle with someone, but then you don't see that same team until like 6-8 weeks down the road. You've already forgotten about it because you've had another rivalry the week after. So, you know, we've got to get over it pretty quick. Otherwise, it's good payback.
Well, I mean, your record's not exactly clean either, to be fair. there was an incident where I believe the roles were slightly reversed.
I think Homebush, we had a run in that same year where, in fairness, there's a lot of high risers there where the sun does come out from behind it, and it actually surprised me, and I think I made contact. So we're all, like I said, rule 101, read the handbook. It's the other person's fault. But unfortunately, he's a nice guy. He smiles. And when he comes up to you and says, when it's your fault, you go, maybe he's right. When I know he's not right, but he's got that little bit of persuading that he can do. So that smile is quite powerful.
Can I go back to the crashes for a second? It was like 154. Mm-hmm. Did you have kind of, were you thinking, I'm nearly there?
It's so close to the end. It's painful, but at the same time, if he doesn't make a move on that lap, he might not get another opportunity. That's what Bathurst is. We all turn the TV on, whether you love motorsport or not, for the last hour of the race. And it's for stuff like that, where there's heroes, there's villains, there's tragic, there's winners, there's losers. And that day, I thought, back to back.
You thought you were the villains.
Back to back, it was looking good. But this race is built on history. And people remember Chaz's win. He led one lap. Yeah. Sorry, he led half a lap. And that was the one that won it. Yeah. We led all day, both of us. And we end up, he got a drive-through, which was
Justified.
And I did a burnout down the straight, which was what it was. But that's Bathurst, that's what it is.
Yeah. Craig, I'll start with you, the fans at the top of the mountain. Can you hear them? What kind of effects are they having on you?
Oh, it's an amazing feeling when you start of the race and the end of the race. Like, it's definitely, you know, you hear the atmosphere and the crowd, because they're elevated above you. It's like an amphitheater effect. And of course, all day they're on the barbecue, they're drinking beer, they're enjoying it. They have a clean pass on another competitor. You hear that going across, there's flags flying, there's all sorts of things going on up there. It's just one of those events where you go to, like, a, you know, a Le Mans 24 hour or a Spa 24 hour, something like that. You get the, you capture that event here.
What about you, Frosty?
Yeah, I think it's the crowd's fantastic. That makes this event, you know, so special, as well as every year there's a story, and this is its own little soap opera, this race. Mm. And we take it to heart from the result point of view, but everyone watching it, it's a little soap opera, and it happens every year. And turn on Sunday afternoon, you will dislike someone,
yep,
you will love someone, and that's just how
it is. Got to take a side.
That's how it is.
I love it. Boys, barbecue time, perfect day for it.
Yeah.
What do you guys like on the tools? You a bit of a barbecue baron?
Normally at home, yeah, if anything to do with barbecue, which we cook salmon, steak, and a few other things on barbecue at home, yeah.
Going outside of snags and steak, very impressive.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't say they're always successful, but yeah, I try.
But the enthusiasm's there, and that's exactly all you can ask for.
Yeah.
What about you, Frosty?
Well, I like going to a mate's place, so, so next week I'm happy to come over and and eat some of your salmon and steak and stuff. But no, I'm getting new into the game. I've been doing a fair bit of spit work and stuff like that. So the next progression's to come on and take ownership of the barbecue. So yeah, I'm a work in progress, but I do know my way around a barbecue. We all do. Every bloke does, don't they? It's like a tradition.
So what are you cooking?
Mate, so we're on the Ziggy trip today. Yeah. I'm going to do a few kebabs for you guys, some lamb, a little bit of chicken, get some veggies in there. I know you guys got a big race coming on. Let's just have a quick check.
You look good.
Mm. Well, talk to me about your barbecue etiquette. Are you a bit of a dictator when it comes to it? You do it your way and no advice from anyone else?
The interesting thing for me is every barbecue's different.
Yeah.
The way that the heat's up the plate and everything else. So you've got to know your barbecue, and if you know your barbecue, don't touch it.
Yeah, okay. Good one about this. So I'm the complete opposite.
Oh, really?
Yeah, love it. More. Tell me what you're doing.
Great. Well, I noticed when you lift the lid up, I wouldn't have done that.
Yeah. I was going to tell you a bit later,
I was going to say off camera, but that's cool.
Look, sometimes the sizzle can be a little bit deceiving. But see, with the Ziggy holds amazing temperature. We're sitting at 200 right now. Just wanted to make sure it was doing it. Good thing about this one, 7-year comprehensive warranty. Mm-hmm. So as you would know, like sometimes if you're trying to travel it around, we've brought this one out to Bathurst today, had to reassemble it. Still killing it. That last one on the right, I think I left it on there a little bit too long.
Yep.
It's probably gonna have a little bit of like residue on there. Cools down, chuck it straight in the dishwasher. Everybody's laughing. Minimal cleanup for me. I reckon we're nearly done, boys.
Yeah.
Get that sizzle.
You better eat.
Ah, mess free.
Look at that.
All right,
beautiful.
Let's get this going. Huge assist to the Ziggy Triple for helping us out today. Yeah. Boys, thanks for joining me around the flame. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Lots to come. And of course, barbecues galore. Now you're cooking.